Good day, everyone, and welcome. Before we start, we have a disclosure. Please be aware of risk in the future trade, and we strongly advise you to stay on the sim as long as needed before you use your real money. We're gonna cover a few auto trades. You have around 14 auto trades in your package. We cover around 2-3 auto trades. This is the automated signal. Right now, we have the less signal on the ES, NASDAQ, and Dow Jones. The less entry signal right now, we have 126 ticks into the profit. The market analyzer is based on one contract. On the scalper, we have 220 based on the last entry. As an example, the YM here, there is 200. Here is 400 because here there is two contract, but the market analyzer is only based on one contract. And this is the last trade for today. We're gonna move to another type of an auto trade, totally different. Today the market was, a trend. It was moving really on the other channel, you can see. It was moving nicely, and then it died out on us today, the market. And let me show you something very interesting here. As we still have a few trades open, this is very unusual. But if we look at the 10 second, we had such a long time, even on the 10 second, look at this. It is a straight line in a way, and this is 10 second. I mean, and that was from 10 o'clock, straight line, and this is 10 seconds, it's not a minute. And one trade, we had one losing trade, and we did a beautiful in here, and then this is the last trade for today. But the results, you can see that there is still a few more charts open, and they've been on that trade for a very long time, and they have not even closed. That indicate the market is not really moving, and some of them, they have been forever there. And the CL, it is okay. You can see how long is this trade here on the 5 minutes ES. And now we just had this trade close on the 25 second. And this trade here has been for, this trade has been since 11 o'clock, and right now is 3:06. So this is a really a long time to open, stay open on a trade. This is the YM 5 minutes. We covered that in the trader on the other channel. You can see again the NASDAQ straight line, and ES 3 minutes, it did very good job, $2,000. And NASDAQ, we always use show you the 590 takes. It's a very consistent every day, the ES we covered. The 5 minutes is still look is the same. And still, there are two the same auto trade, the same chart, but one of them is on one account and the other one is on different account. That's why you see the same chart, because they are on two different accounts. You can do that. If you have two different accounts, you can do that. You can put one on that account and one on the other account. So this is the precision auto trade. It is a friendly use, not very hard to control. I want to cover the scalper. I don't have that much room to put many charts on a different auto trades, but this is an idea of the scalper. And I mainly use the scalper on 30 second or you can use it on 1 minute, and I like to use it on range. And this is the ES, and they're both on the range, and you can see they do a good job actually. Also, you can see this one is with a filter, one is without a filter, but it doesn't matter the PNL. What it did on this one here, this is a new template we made today. One trade, two trade, three trade, four trade, not even one losing trade. That's what it counts. The scalper is extremely friendly use, not complicated. You can even use it as a default setting, but we strongly recommend to learn it. And the earlier time we also, this one here took a three trade, and it was done. This is a really friendly use, Autotrader. It's not hard to, especially for beginners. Let's say if you want to measure this Autotrader with more advanced automated trade, this is a total different type of an Autotrader. This kind of Autotrader is so you don't have a clients all in one line. You have advanced traders, beginners, and this is for somebody really understand the concept of trading. This is a very advanced automated trade, and actually not too many people can. This is really not for retailers, honestly. We have developed that many years ago, and we just updated. And this is a really measuring from 1 to 30 minutes, 1 to 30 minutes. There is some other instruments, and measuring tick by tick. And this is a really, and you can cut it the way you want it. And it's very advanced with parabolic trailing. It can reverse, and you can filter it, measuring three different high time frame. At the same time, you can measure the buyers and the sellers in the market, and then on top of the measuring the buyers and the seller is measuring six different time frame. This is a very high advanced automated trade. So for a guy, I mean, you cannot have them all in one piece. For a guy is a beginner, this is much more easy. I mean, it's less complicated. You just put it and optimize only the time frame, work for it. This is for a guy who wanna go head to head with the market, for serious traders, and they're both are excellent. And so this one here is the easiest one. This one here also easy, very easy, and they are very consistent, and they are very efficient. I don't know what happened tomorrow. I cannot predict tomorrow what will happen, but our experience, those are very consistent. And then we have another one, total different Autotrader. It's a mid-size, has 10 different entries and 10 different filters. The TI7 is a totally different Autotrade than the others, with a 10 different entry, 10 different filters. You can scalp the market, you can auto-trail the market, you can put it on zero and let the auto trade take a direction or close a position once the trend is over. This one is a mid-size auto trade. This is the CL 540 takes. Look, here we are scalping the CL and took a beat, which is nine range. Took a beat today. It was a lot of a small losing trade in there, and that one here didn't do well because of this small trades in and out, and that is caused not by your auto trade, by the market movement. Here we started very well, then we had one losing trade, that's why the delay. But then at the end took the from if you notice that trade has been from 1 o'clock and now it's at 3:19. You can see how slow this market is, and that's why we have a few trades still open. On the precision auto trade, the 590 ticks for the Nasdaq is an excellent template. On the TI7 is 520. Small losing trade, break even plus couple takes. Close trade, reverse. This one here have three different scalpers, one reversal as an entry, and the other straight with a trend, and then reverse the market. This is beautiful. Reverse the market, and it was done by 11 o'clock, 11:41. That was beautiful. On the Nasdaq, the 4 minutes did very well. It's not the P&L I look after as much as how many losing trade we had and how many winning trade we have. I didn't start from 7:30. We started around 9:30, and we took a first trade, losing trade. One, two, three, four, five, and it was done. So it took a five trades. At the start, we have a losing trade, and when the markets start getting aligned, and as you see, it was zero losing trade. This is what is the most important. The losing trades are much less than the winning trade, and you take it day by day. I don't know how much it will be tomorrow or a day after tomorrow. I cannot look at the future. I don't know if the CL is gonna be bad movement tomorrow or a good movement until we open NinjaTrader in the morning and see how the market situation. This one here is very impressive, the 5 minute CL. We are running on a very small tight stop loss. You can see how tight it is, very small, you know, and the way it chased this market is beautiful. Break even when the market turned around, losing trade. It didn't do well, broke even plus a couple takes, but we started today around 9 o'clock, 9:30. So here, most likely we started here today. When the market took the spike, nailed the second round, and this is what really nice. This is just like to show to our fellow traders, they insist on keep trading. If you notice, when the CL spiked, you did very well, and this is really the rest of the day was not much movement. So that could have caused losses, or you can double up. I mean, nobody knows what happened in the future. But my thinks is if you make it from 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock, you should turn on a sim in the afternoon to protect your profit. Keep auto trading day and night. It's not really healthy. It's like you're sitting in Las Vegas all day long. It's a matter of time before you start giving back all your profit. So if the market, there is enough beef in there, you should get your beef from 9:30 to 11, 12 o'clock. And if it's the market not working, you should stop and live for another day. On the precision auto trade, the 4 minutes and the 5 minutes are excellent. They work hand in hand with the time frame. On the TI-7, works on 2 minutes. It is the best time frame for the DAX. So a different entry works different approach. So that's why there is 10 different entries, not because we just wanna add entries. Because the entry on the DAX does not mean the same entry is gonna work on the ES. It's a total different animal. What works on the ES is not gonna work on the NASDAQ. The filter you use on the ES is not gonna work on the NASDAQ. So that idea that if you think you have one auto trade and you can nail all the market because you have one auto trade, this is sad. It's like, you know, you're going on one wheel and if you have a flat tire, you're doomed. I wanna say thank you very much. God bless you all. And we'll see you tomorrow live on the other channel. Bye for now.